It's been a while since I posted my last video, and I have been getting more subscribers and more people that seem to be interested in the air engine research that I've been doing, and I decided to put together a video history of how I started, what kind of ideas I came up with, some of them which were not very good. Some didn't work at all, some worked pretty well, and with modifications and over time as I developed it, it got better and better. The final version that I have now, I'm trying to figure out what I can do to get something or somehow the compressed air that would be required and a tank of some sort that would be able to hold the compressed air up to like 5,000 PSI in enough quantity to be able to go for, say, a couple of hundred miles. But at this point, I'm kind of at a standstill, so I thought I'd do this video.
My air motor. Well, I made quite a few changes in my valve system. Everything now is on the inside here, whereas before it was out here. I made some changes on things so that it's not quite as noisy, but still pretty noisy. I guess a good precision made parts and stuff would make it a lot quieter, but right now my main thing is just to see that I get it to work and see how well it works. And with what I've got, it does. can't hold it back, so I don't know how much torque it's got, but that's running about somewhere around 100 psi, 80 to 100 psi. Keep the pistons on the ring, otherwise I'm going to have a problem. Okay, I've got my motor working, but it's still pretty far out of balance, so I'm going to have to do more work on that. It runs about 540 RPMs at about 100 PSI, and I've got it now on four cylinders. The valve here will allow it to go two cylinders or four cylinders, but right now I've just got it set up to four. Runs pretty good, pretty fast. This is my latest version of my four-cylinder air engine running in a groove, and it's running right now at 55 PSI, about 330 RPMs. If I go to 100, it goes up to about 1100 RPMs. Balance problems, but I think I'm going to replace the cylinders, which right now are solid steel cylinders about 8 inches long, and it's about an inch and an eighth in diameter, so it's making it pretty much out of balance when it runs, I think. Thank you. Okay, this is my V4 air engine. It's running at 100 PSI right now. The first time around made the camera shake, so now I'm going to redo it. Latest version of my air engine. I'll have to take it apart and redo the valves and make this different, and then I'm going to have to take these all off and cut the ends out so I can get it on and off without taking it completely off. And when I have it off, I'm going to weld the cams, weld some of the other things, and we'll go from there. I've been working on redesigning my oval six-cylinder engine here the last couple of months, and I've pretty well got it going where I'm starting to put it together now. I've still got to make some pistons and do some things like that, but the basic design I have done now, and this is going to be where the outside rotates. Internal parts are stationary, so it will rotate in such a manner. Okay, now I have all six cylinders hooked together and in running order, but I still have the problem with the outer ring making contact with the pistons at all times. So
We'll just have to see what happens. Okay, over the past week or so, I've been working on the valve assembly right here, trying to make it more compact and more easily assembled and disassembled if I need to work on something. So
I think I've got that pretty well done. And I've also included an upper and lower seal in there now so that the air doesn't leak around the valve. I think the prototype is pretty well complete as far as what I need to do to make sure that it works and does what I want it to do. Next thing I'll work on will be the air tank and an assembly for adding air to whatever vehicle I'm going to try to put it in. But it works pretty fair so far. It starts and stops in just any position, so you don't need a starter. Running at probably 110 psi, and it's pretty responsive in starting and stopping. I don't know what the torque will be yet, but it will have a fair amount of torque, I'm sure.
I have my air engine mounted on the back of my mower vehicle, and I don't have a high pressure tank yet, so I'm running off of my air compressor at 125 psi. The engine ratio is 3.25 revolutions per one revolution of the tire. I know I'm going to have a transmission to get it going, but once it's running or moving, I think it'll be okay with that ratio of straight through. So we'll just see how fast it goes and let you see how the wheel turns. Since I put the engine and eighth cylinders on there, it does vibrate a little more than what it did with the 7/8 cylinders, but for just being roughly put together with things that I could get, pieces I, you know, cut out and welded or whatever myself, I think it did pretty well. So we'll let it at that for now.
Okay, I got the thing set at 300 psi. What was the first year, and it goes pretty fair. I don't want to run through the door, and I have to set it off short. There we go. Again. takes off pretty good, anyway. As long as you keep the...
I've been working on cylinder number 6 for the last couple days, and I think I got it pretty much the way it has to be. I put the brackets on, and I made some side brackets to support the push rods whenever the shaft comes around and opens and closes the valves. And I tried it a while ago, and to my surprise, this thing started running on one cylinder. So I'll let you see it. Maybe it'll do it again. We'll wait and see. Wow. That's my one cylinder, but it like gets up and goes, doesn't it? Well, I'm going to keep working on it a little bit more and see what happens. Shut the air off that time. There. Put it back on. I noticed a little while ago when I was showing you how it runs on 2, 4, and 6 cylinders, it wasn't running quite right on 2 cylinders. So I took the plate off the end of the intake and the little washer valve that seals the inside. The bolt had come loose, so I need to use Loctite or something, I guess, on the bolt when I put that in. I'm running now on the latest cam design, which keeps the valves open a little bit longer, both the intake and the exhaust, and that seems to be working pretty good. torque, it would twist the motor, but it doesn't seem to be doing that. I've been working on the double valves. I have cylinders, what is it? One, three, five set up, and the double valve camshafts, after several variations and revised, I got it finally, I think, to where it's working pretty good. And also I have a balance disc on the shaft, so it seems to be running pretty smooth. It's just free setting on the on top of my workbench, so whenever I run it and accelerate, it'll probably want to spin. So we'll just have to see how that goes. But right now I'm running it on 90 PSI and see how it goes. Today I have the metal cams on it and also the counterbalance cams so that it doesn't shake around too much. It does still want to twist whenever you accelerate it, but that's because it's just sitting on the table without any support or anything. But it does seem to run a little better with it. I'm still going to have to do some more timing on it and make some new ends for the push rods. They were wore from when I had the wooden cams on there, and they don't seem to be wearing now, so that's good. So anyway, this is what it does. Seems to run pretty good, although I'm sure it'll be a little bit better when I get it a little more accurate and get some of the seals and stuff underneath the cylinders, which I don't have right now. And also I have to put seals around the push rods, which I don't have. And I'm thinking I might want to go to 3/8 push rods instead of quarters. We'll have to see. the seals underneath the cylinders where they go. And I've got lines all hooked up. I added an on-off valve and adjusted the timing on everything, so it should be ready to go, hopefully. And we'll see if it starts on two cylinders, four cylinders, six cylinders. It should start, but if not, if you go into any of the others, it'll start. So I've been working on the valve pushrod system for the last week, making parts and putting it together, and I finally have it ready to try running. We'll see how it goes. I'll start off with two cylinders. Yeah, if it goes.